Minneapolis City Council made good on its promise to push through a Gaza ceasefire resolution.
In a 9-3 vote, council members voted to override Mayor Frey's veto of the measure. And at the same time, Mayor Frey introduced his own proclamation supporting a ceasefire and recognizing a two-state solution in the Middle East. Gordon Severson is here now with more from city leaders. Gordon?
Yeah, if you read the mayor's proclamation and the council's resolution, they are almost identical in terms of what they stand for. But the mayor argues the council's version is one-sided when it comes to the history of the conflict and Israeli Jews. So he released his own version this morning.
That motion carries, the veto is overturned, and the original resolution is adopted.
The Minneapolis City Council's decision was unchanged after a veto from the mayor. In a 9-3 vote, the council approved the call for a ceasefire in the Middle East.
This is not a normal ceasefire resolution.
Mayor Jacob Frey released his own ceasefire proclamation Thursday that is similar to the council's resolution in many ways. The main difference involves this paragraph that Frey argues shows a historical perspective from the Palestinian side of the conflict, but doesn't provide any context regarding Jewish history. In the mayor's proclamation, the historical perspective from both sides has been omitted, instead focusing on the current conflict overseas.
We can acknowledge one group's and ethnicity's pain, the horrible killings that have happened to one, while simultaneously not depriving the other of their history. And when you say to provide context and you only give one-sided context, that's wrong.
This is about a ceasefire.
Andrea Jenkins is one of the 9 council members who voted in favor of the ceasefire resolution, but she understands the mayor's viewpoint.
I mean, I agree that it is one-sided. So I did have a chance to see the mayor's proclamation, and I think that balanced things a little bit.
The president and vice president of the council released a joint statement after the vote saying, "We are proud of the 9 council members who stood by what most Minneapolis residents believe. The defense of humanity is a shared project. We hope this is the last time we will be faced with a veto this term."
Now, several other cities have also passed ceasefire resolutions, and many of them have been contentious as well. In Chicago, the city council was split on the idea, so the mayor had to be the deciding vote. Meanwhile, there are many people on social media who argue these city councils should focus on local issues and not an overseas conflict where they don't have any authority. So again, a very contentious issue. Back to you.
All right, Gordon, thanks. Also,